Welcome to experiment number 7 of electrical machines lab. We are going to perform the no load test, block rotor test and load test on 3-phase squirrel cage induction motor. Here all the supply that we are going to give is AC compared to the previous experiment where we have given the DC supply. Instead of having a 3-point starter, in case of AC motors, we will be using a dual starter, that is the direct online starter. And the rotor that we are using is basically delta connected rotor. To measure the current, voltage, power and power factor, we have a multifunction meter. In order to perform the load test, we have a load connected mechanically to the rotor shaft. Now, to perform the block rotor test, we can control the voltage using an auto transformer. Now, we will see the connection of no load test first, then we'll perform the load test, and finally, we will go for block rotor test. Let us start the connection. So first we are going to perform the no load test. Now we are going to connect the R phase of the 3-phase supply to the input, one of the input of the dual starter. The second Y phase of the input is connected to the other end of the dual starter. The B phase of the 3-phase supply is connected to the third input of the dual starter. The output of the dual starter is connected to one of the input of the multifunction meter. The second output of the dual starter is connected to the second input of the multifunction meter. The third output of the dual starter is connected to the third input of the multifunction meter. All the three outputs of the multifunction meter are connected to the rotor of the induction motor. So the R phase will be connected to the R, the Y phase will be connected to the Y, and the B phase will be connected to the B phase of the rotor. The red, yellow and blue phase are basically shown by its colors, red, yellow and blue. The multifunction meter can measure the voltage, current, power and power factor, and there is a meter to measure the speed, which is the RPM meter. The load is mechanically coupled to the rotor shaft. So first we will do the no load test and then we'll go for the load test. To perform the no load test, the spring of the load has to be kept loose and no load has to be put in the machine. So this is basically, we can say, as open circuit test. Switch on the MCB, then turn on the meter. Press the blue button in the dual starter, that is the on button. This will start the motor. The motor has to be kept at the no load condition. Press the voltage button in the multifunction meter. After two pressing, note down the average voltage in the multifunction meter. That will be the no load voltage, since no load is connected. Then measure the current by pressing the second button. The power and power factor are measured by pressing the other third and the fourth button of the multifunction meter. Now the no load test is over. So before switching off the motor, press the red button in the dual starter and then turn off the MCV. Switch off the meter panel. Now we are going to take the reading of load test. So turn on the MCV and press the meter panel. Now switch on the starter by pressing the blue button. The motor will start. It is under no load condition. Now slowly we are going to add the load on the motor so that there is a change in the current displayed on the multifunction meter. On changing the load, we will see that there is an increase in the current. The no load current was around 3 ampere, so we can add 1 ampere each step to note down the reading till the rated current.
We write the rate 3.1, current rate down 4 amps. We write down 1.795. Speed write down 1482.
So we have to note down the voltage, current, power, power factor and the speed.
Power factor write down 0.708. S1 is 2 kilo, S3 8 kilo.
So after taking the first reading, we will increase the load by pouring little bit water so that the motor do not heats up. A little amount of water has to be poured in the rotor shaft so that the motor do not heats up and cools down. Because as we increase the load, the motor starts increasing. Now we are increasing the load to take the second reading to a step of 1 ampere each. We can take the reading.
The write down voltage 374, current write down 5.26, speed write down 2.68, arc speed write down 1469, power factor write down 0.8.
So
S1 is to write down S1 3 kilo, S2 4 kilo, 14 kilo.
So in the second reading, we will be noting down the voltage, current, power factor and speed corresponding to the two different loads that we are putting, S1 and S2. Now we will keep on increasing the load till the rated current is reached. The rated current of the motor is 7.5 amps. So we will increase the load till 7.5 amps is displayed in the multifunction meter.
Write down V 357, I write down current 7.6, P write down 4.168, speed 1431, power factor 0.899, S1 4 kilo, S2 23.
So at the rated condition, we are noting down the power, voltage, current, speed and the load S1 and S2. Now the readings are over. So before switching off, we will reduce the load to the no load condition. Then we are going to turn off the starter and switch off the MCB. Now we are going to perform the block rotor test. In the block rotor test, it is basically the short circuit test. So full load rated current has to be supplied. Also, we required an auto transformer so that the voltage is slowly varied in the machine. The input of the auto transformer is connected to the input of the supply. So the R phase is connected to the input of the R of the auto transformer. The Y of the auto transformer is connected to the Y of the input supply. The B phase of the input supply is connected to the B phase of the auto transformer input. And there is a neutral point which is connected to the auto transformer of the supply and the auto transformer. The output, similarly, the R phase, Y phase and B phase are connected to the input of the multifunction meter. So R, Y, B of the output of the auto transformer is connected to R, Y, B of the input of the multifunction meter. The output of the multifunction meter is connected to the rotor shaft and the load is connected. In this test, we do not require the DOL starter. So we have removed the connection. Now we are going to turn on the MCB. First, we will be keeping the load in the no load conditions. So keep the load under no load condition and then turn on the MCB. After the MCB is turned on, switch on the meter, multifunction meter. Now slowly vary the voltage from the auto transformer and vary the auto transformer voltage so that the rated current of the machine is reached. Also, slowly tight up the load, put up the load in the machine and slowly vary the voltage. The current displayed in the multifunction meter has to reach the rated current. This condition is displayed as the block rotor condition or the short circuit condition. Now record the voltage and current power shown in the multifunction meter.
Write down the V 85.1, current write down 7.5, V write down 0.698, power factor write down 0.627.
Now we have to record the reading for voltage, current, power and power factor. We can observe that the speed displayed on the meter is zero because the rotor is blocked. This, after completing the experiment, slowly convert the auto transformer to the 0 volt and turn off the MCB. Keep the load in the minimum position or the no load condition. Switch off the meter. This completes the block rotor test on squirrel cage induction motor.